family of God. You're born again, you come into the family of God. You need to find out, what's the commandment here? What's the lifestyle here? What's the law here? What's the rule here? You need to know that so that you will know how to live as a member of the family of God, the great commandment in God's family. Number three, the great commission for God's family. The great commission for God's family. Understand? This commission is only for the members of the family. Sometimes we have people outside the family and they're trying the worst they can do. They think they're doing the best they can do to carry out the commission. It's not for them. They're strangers to the commission. They're strangers to the covenant. They're strangers to the work that belongs to the family. And it's only the people who are members of the family of God that can do this. Sometimes you find people like the Pharisees, they run across the sea. And they run across every land to make one proselyte, to make one convert. And they're trying, they say they're evangelizing. But the commission doesn't belong to those who are not members of the family of God. Sometimes you find a whole denomination of people and they do not know what it means to be members of the family of God. And they're very active. And you see signboard here, poster here, and they try to evangelize. Listen, the commission is for the family. The great commission for God's family. Actually, they are not serving the Lord in all those things they are doing. Until they become members of the family of God, the commission is not for them. We're coming to number one. What's number one over there? The great characteristics of God's family. And we need to understand this very well. You need to understand this yourself so that you will be able to answer the question, am I a member of the family of God? Am I in? Because you have to find that out before you see your part in the commandment and the commission. Romans chapter 6 and chapter 9. And I'm reading from verse 6. Romans chapter 9, verse 6. Not as though the word of God has taken on effect, for they are not all Israel which are of Israel. They are not all Israel which are of Israel. Those who are born of the flesh and they count themselves as Israelites. The word of God says no. They are not all Israel who are of Israel. There must be another characteristic apart from the physical birth. Apart from I was born there. I belong to them. There must be something more than that. We're looking at John chapter 2. John chapter 2, and we're reading from verse 23. Now, when he was in Jerusalem at the Passover, in the feast day, many believed on his name. When they saw the miracles which he did. Here is where many people take a wrong step or they have a misunderstanding concerning who are members of the family of God. I believe. Hold on. What do you believe? Who do you believe? How do you believe? What's the consequence of that believing? When they saw his miracles, many believed on him. Look at verse 24. But Jesus did not commit himself unto them because he knew all men. And he needed not that any should testify of man, for he knew what was in man. He knew what was in them. They believed in miracles. They didn't believe on Jesus Christ as Savior, as Redeemer, as the only way to God. They did not believe as the only one that will make the sacrifice and reconcile them unto the Lord. They saw a miracle. I believe in miracles. You can even go beyond believing in miracles and do miracles yourself. You are still not part of the family. Matthew chapter 7. In Matthew chapter 7, I'm reading here from verse 21. Matthew chapter 7, verse 21. Not everyone that says unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but he that doeth the will of my Father which is in heaven. Many will say to me in that day, Lord, Lord, have we not prophesied in thy name? And in thy name have cast out devils, and in thy name have done many wonderful works. And then when I profess unto them, I never knew you, depart from me, ye that work iniquity. Their inside internal life has not been cleansed. They were still working iniquity, and somehow they believe that God is mighty. Unbelievers believe that. Somehow they believe that God is a great God who has created the whole universe. Unbelievers believe that too. Even Satan believes that. They believe that as God was powerful in the days gone by, God is powerful today. The unbelievers believe that too. They believe that Jesus Christ is a mighty miracle worker. Unbelievers believe that too. And they believe that even Jesus can heal the sick today. And when they tell people that Jesus can heal them today, the people accept. And on the basis of accepting that truth, not on the basis of the way he lives, not on the basis of the way he actually conducts his life, on the basis of the fact that they say, God heals, yes, I accept. Jesus heals, yes, I accept. If we pray in the name of Jesus will heal you. And so the people accepted and they are healed. And they took that to me. And now a member of the family of God. I'm working miracles. I'm healing the sick. I'm prophesying. Balaam prophesied. Even the ass spoke in tongues and spoke the words with the tongue of a man. That doesn't make that ass a child of God. That doesn't make that ass a member of the family of God. I believe in miracles. That's not enough. I'm working miracles. That's not enough. There must be something beyond just working miracles, seeing miracles, and prophesying that makes us children of God. I want you to look at 2 Timothy. 2 Timothy, we're looking at chapter 3. And we're looking at verse 5. 2 Timothy chapter 3. And in verse 5, it says, having a form of godliness. A form of godliness. Externally, they act like the children of God. Externally, they act as if we're there too. We're with you too. But it says, but denying the power thereof, from such, turn away. The power to overcome sin, that one they deny. The power to live a victorious life, that one they deny. And the power to obey the commandments of God, that one they deny. And yet, they have a form of godliness. They go to church, they are baptized in water, either as infant or adult. They take the Holy Communion, but they deny the power of God. It says, turn away from them, they are not part of God's family. Titus chapter 1. In Titus chapter 1, reading from verse 16, it says, they profess, they testify, they proclaim that they know God, but in works they deny him. Their character is different. Their lifestyle is different. Their disposition very different. Interact with them in business and you will know who they are. Interact with them in your family. You will know who they are. Commit something like money into their hands. You'll know who they are. You cannot trust them. They are not faithful. When they see money, money is their master. It controls them. They steal out of it. They do whatever they want to do with it. And then they tell you lie. They profess that they know God. But in words, they deny him, being abominable, disobedient, and to every good work, reprobate. They're reprobates. They're not members of the family of God. We need to understand when it says the great commandment in God's family. Who are the members of the family of God? And there are people during this December period, you will see them in their colorful dresses, and you will see them go shopping, and you say, well, we're shopping for Christmas. And you ask them, what is Christmas? And they say, you don't know. Then they begin to tell stories. How Christ was born. How this one happened. How that happened. How are you sure that December 25 is the birthday of the Lord Jesus Christ? Oh, they say everybody believes that and we believe that. Anyway, don't waste my time. I need to go shopping. But they say there is no money around now, that the economy is biting hard. And they say, even though the economy is biting hard, we need to buy this and buy this, and then the nightclubs are filled up. The drinking multiplies. Traveling up and down multiplies. And those are children of God. First Timothy chapter 5. In 1 Timothy chapter 5, we're looking at verse 6. 1 Timothy chapter 5, verse 6. But she that liveth in pleasure is dead while she liveth. She that liveth in pleasure, the nightclubs, the drinking, the smoking, the hard drugs, the fornication, the adultery. Looks like the way they understand Christmas. Christmas is for drunkenness. Christmas is for fornication. And Christmas is for the old boyfriends and old girlfriends to come back again. It's for the pleasure, for the lust of the flesh. Those are not children of God. You know that. She that liveth in pleasure is dead while she liveth. In 2 Kings chapter 17. 2 Kings chapter 17. I'm reading from verse 33 and verse 34. 2 Kings chapter 17. Verse 33. It says, they feared the Lord. Don't stop there. If they feared the Lord, you think those are the children of God. There's something again in their lives. It's not loving God with all their heart, all their soul, all their mind. It says they feared the Lord and served their own gods. They feared the Lord on Sunday and they served their own gods during the week. They say, Abba, Father, on Sunday, a Father which art in heaven on Sunday. And then during the week, they go to their idols, to their gods, and to their occultism, and they go to all those evil things, traditional things. They fear the Lord and serve their own gods after the manner of the nations whom they carried away from this. They had overcome some other nations, and they say, God has given us victory. We're victorious over these people. They learned about their gods and they served them. Verse 34, unto this day, they do after their former manners. Nothing has changed. Lying before, lying continues. Stealing before, stealing continues. Fighting before, fighting continues. Fornication continues. Adultery, messing up with other people's wives, other people's husbands, that continues. They say, well, we're Christians. We're children of God. They even claim to be born again nowadays, but nothing has changed until this day. They do after their former manners. They fear not the Lord. In reality, they fear not the Lord. Neither do they after their statutes or after their ordinances or after the law and commandments which the Lord commanded the children of Judah, whom he named Israel, who then are the children of God. How do you know whether you are a child of God or not? How do you mark yourself out? And you can say, I am a child of God. Let God himself tell you who are his own children. The characteristics, great characteristics of God's children, of God's family. In 2 Corinthians chapter 6. 2 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 17. Wherefore, come out from among them, and be ye separate, says the Lord. Here is the Lord saying, you want to be a child of God? You want to show that you are a child of God? Here is the evidence. Here is the mark. Here is the characteristic. Wherefore, come out from among them, and be ye separate, says the Lord, and touch not the unclean thing, and I will receive you. Before that, I can't receive you. I can't accept you. Still chewing your tobacco, I cannot receive you. Still belonging to the occult, I cannot receive you. And still committing the fornication, I cannot receive you. Still in drunkenness, I cannot accept you. Come out from among them and touch not. Don't drink, don't even touch. Don't smoke, don't even touch. Don't worship idol, don't even touch. Touch not the unclean thing. Don't commit fornication, don't even touch her. Don't touch the prostitute. Have nothing to do with her. Touch not the unclean thing. Anything that makes you unclean, makes you unholy, anything that will defile you, don't even touch. And I will receive you, and I will be a father unto you. Listen to this. And you shall be my sons and my daughters, says the Lord Almighty. The characteristics of those who are members of the family of God, they are the people that know sin as sinful. They know sin as awful. They know sin as horrible. They know sin as dangerous. And they come out of sin and they will not even touch. Those are the people, they have repented of their sins. They have believed on the Lord Jesus Christ. And as they believe, after that repentance, then they are now children of God. The characteristics of God's family. John chapter 1, reading from verse 12. But as many as received him, not as many as received miracle, that's receiving it. As received baptism, that's receiving it. As received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name. Matthew chapter 12. In Matthew chapter 12, the Lord Jesus makes it very clear who are members of the family of God. Matthew chapter 12, verse 49. And he stretched forth his hand towards his disciples and said, behold my mother and my brethren, for whosoever shall do, not just profess, not just say, not just have a form of godliness, whosoever shall do the will of my Father, which is in heaven, the same is my brother and sister and mother. That's the family of God. They are born again. They have repented and turned away from sin. And they believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. And grace has entered, coming to them. And by that grace, they are now able to do the will of God. We're looking at John, 1 John chapter 3. 1 John chapter 3. And we're reading from verse 1. It says in 1 John chapter 3, verse 1. Behold, what manner of love the Father has bestowed upon us, that we should be called the sons of God, that we should be called members of the family.